Okay, so it's where we ended. We have to represent the image of our slab there. That's our next target. Okay, so for that, I'll have to put a push button here. Okay, the push button is meant to contain the image, right? So calculating the position, I'll just need to come and look here. Following X, I'll have 136 and 50. Okay, so let us put a push button there. We'll call it sec window. By now, you should know why every secondary widget like that, I'm creating it under inside sec window. So you have UI control. By default, what happens? By default, the style of UI control is a push button. So UI control. And I'll just say position. Position, okay. And position here we have 136. I'm measuring it from the centimeter, okay. So I want to measure it from here, from the end of this. I'll give a certain distance, maybe of I don't know 100. Okay, then I'll create a push button somewhere down here. So we'll just do this by some form of trial and error. Okay, so I'll say 136, 1365 rather, plus 50 gives me 1405. No, 1415. Okay, so I'll have 1415, but this 1415 must be plus 100, so I'll have 1515, 1515. Oh, okay, and it should go down, not up. Okay, so I'll take this 645 and I'll also deduce it maybe by 100. So that's where we'll really do the trial and error one. And let's say it has to be, we'll put it 100 by 100 and see what comes out of it. Okay, good. So let's try to see where it happens. Okay, but that 100 by 100 is too small, right? Let's try to give it a bigger dimension. We'll say 200 by 200 and see what it gives. We really want the geometry to be apparent. Okay, yes, I think it's better this way, but now we have to move it down. So let's move it down maybe to, let's move it down to, let's say, to 300 and try to see what it gives. Oh, 400 then. Okay, 400 it is, right? There's a bit of experience in this too, huh? Don't cry. So we have to represent the image of our slab here, okay? The geometry that we want to be seen here. So how do we do that? So for this particular case, I will show, okay, but in the other cases for BIM and all that, I will have to create the images myself in order to save time, okay? Knowing that you can already create the image from this example that we have right here. Okay, so let's go. This is the image we are talking about, the one for slab. This is the image right here. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll come here to Windows and I'll call capture. Uti capture, I think it's something like snapshot in English. Okay, so I'll say uti capture. The outil capture will enable me to have a specific geometry. Okay, let me come here to even options, because I need it to be what? I need it to be square, right? You remember? I need it to be totally squared. Is there a possibility for it to be square here? Okay, no problem. Okay, no problem. We'll deal with it as it comes. So let's give enough space so that we can actually make it the way we want to make it. That's what we are interested in. If I say Uti here, what's that? Option. Again, back to those options. Fichier. Okay, no problem. So we have to save this, okay? So we will save it. Where are we going to save it? Let's just save it on our main programming path there, okay? Our programming path is in documents and MATLAB. Document, come on. My main path is in document and MATLAB. Okay. Or I'll take this CBD and image. Yes, let me put it here. So I'll call this image slab job. Okay. Let's just call it like that. So what does it mean? Where have I saved it? If I go to my path, this is the main path here. Okay. So when I say main path, it means this is where our file, the file that is executing, the OSA, is being saved. Okay. And where I have saved it is in this folder here, CBD. Okay. CBD image. This is it here, slabjoe.gpg. Okay. So this is the problem. We will have to, let's go and locate it. Okay. I can locate it on this from there, I think so. Let's locate it on disk. Okay. So listen, we will have to change the size of our image to be proportional to the size of our push button. What does it mean? It means that if our push button is square, then the size of our image should be square. It should not necessarily be the same size as our push button, but at least it should be square. It should be the same proportion. Okay, if we have a width that is twice the height, okay, of in our push button, then the image I want to put on it, if we want it to fill the whole space and to fit perfectly, then it also has to be that same proportion. It's very important. So here I'll open it with paint in order to make it square, to edit it for it to become square. Let's open it with paint. Okay, so this is it. We'll go to redimensionner. Okay. Conserver les proportions. No. Okay, we don't want to do that. So let's try to instead reduce, for example, this. Let's put it to 225 and see what happens. Is it possible? Let's click on OK and see what happens. No. Come on, we'll edit it directly from here, okay? Are you seeing here? Oh, what do I have to do here? 255. Okay. So, are you seeing that? Now, if I come back again to the dimensions, and I go to pixel, I have 255 by 255. So it's square. Okay. And that is my image there. So that's perfect. Okay. So what can I do here? It's okay. So can close it. It's asking me to save. Yes, I want to save it. So now the proportions are the same. I can now go back to my MATLAB and just put it on. Okay. Put it on this push button here. How do I put an image on the push button? Well, I just edit the C data property of that push button. Okay, so the push button has a C data property, which enables me to put an image. So to put the image there, I have to read the image. Okay, and to read an image, I use the function imread of. Now I need to put the path of the image, where the path of the image here. Okay, so because my image is already found on the, because my image is already found on my main path, I can just start by writing the name of the folder where it is found here. Okay, this is it here, cbd bs, and then image. Okay, because it's already found on this part, I can just write cbd bs 8110. Where is the code? So I'll say cbd-bs8, come on, 8110, then slash. Is it even this slash? I'm not sure. Is this slash? It should be the other one, right? It should be the divided by slash. Right deviation. Okay. Oh. Anyway, we'll correct it. Okay. We'll just try one. Try the other. I don't quite remember which one it is. So CBDBS8110. Then we'll have what image. Let's go and make sure that our spelling of image. The spelling here should be correct. There should be no mistake. So when I enter here, come on. I have image. It's capital I, right? Okay. I have image, okay, and then I have my slap, right, which is what? Slap Joe as the image of my slap dot gpj. So all of this must be placed as a string like that. Okay, so we'll see. If this does not work, then we'll have to change it. Okay. So let's do this first for you to see how it. Okay, so that did not work. Let's go and check why it did not work. Does not exist. CPD, what, Slap Joe does not exist? Are you serious? Let's try and change and put the anti slash here. I'm not sure that's the problem anyway. Okay, so what's the error now? Error, okay, you see, it says again does not exist. Wow. So we'll have to change. Let's put GPG and see what it gives. Wow, we're really going by trial and error here, right? Oh, again, and again. Many pings. I don't like hearing pings. This does not work, then we have a very big problem somewhere. There is a problem somewhere, okay? Okay, we'll solve that problem in the next video. Oh, the time is already passed. Okay, so thank you very much for watching. See you in the next video.